federal study will examine whether COVID vaccines can affect a woman's menstrual cycle. Here to answer your questions about that, Dr. Helen Boucher, who's the interim dean at Tufts Medical School and an infectious disease specialist at Tufts Medical Center. Dr. Boucher, good to see you.
Nice to see you, Ben.
Yeah, I want to get right into it here. Some women are reporting that their cycles are heavier, more painful after getting a shot. Do you think that there's a possible link there?
Well, you know, it's a very interesting question, and I think it's good that the study is being done. The question is that there's perhaps an immune mechanism that might cause this. I think it's important to stress, however, that this is very different than any concerns about fertility, which now have been completely disproven. So I don't want anyone to confuse those two issues.
I'm actually glad you brought that up, because Jessica and I were just talking about it, because that does seem to be one of the big questions that persists for some people, but it's good to know that that's now by the boards. Well, the National Institutes of Health is spending $1.6 million to fund research at five institutions, includes BU and Harvard. How long will it take till we have results?
You know, they're estimating that the results may be back by the end of 2022, so just over a year from now. And it's important that this kind of information is collected. And I think, you know, it's interesting to note that this information was not collected in the clinical trials, and hopefully that will change going forward.
Okay. You know, we want to go back to this whole thing about the cycle and the vaccines. I know there's some unanswered questions about vaccines and menstruation, but it makes some women anxious for some reason, more hesitant about getting vaccinated. What do you want them to know overall about this?
Yeah, I think it's really important to emphasize a couple of key points, right? We now have data from animal studies that there's no connection between vaccines and any kind of fertility. We have data from millions of women who've been studied now in the vaccine trials, and the CDC has three separate databases tracking this, and they released data again on August 11th showing absolutely no concerns regarding fertility with the vaccines. And most importantly, we know that the vaccines keep pregnant moms and nursing moms from getting COVID. And we know that COVID is dangerous to both mom and the baby. And then last, and perhaps most importantly, there's now evidence that the antibodies that the mom makes transfer over to the baby. So getting vaccinated is not just protecting yourself as a mom, but also your baby. So lots of reasons for mothers to be vaccinated when they're pregnant. And all of the OBGYN societies and other expert groups are recommending that pregnant mothers and nursing mothers be vaccinated to protect themselves and their baby.
So, Dr. Boucher, I want to ask you one more time, just to make sure it's clear, because that myth does seem to persist, connecting these vaccines to potential infertility. You say there's no data to prove that. In fact, the data has proved that that is false, correct?
That is correct. There is no data making that link, and the vaccines have been shown to be safe in pregnant mothers.
All right, Dr. Helen Boucher, interim dean at Tufts, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.